remember when you were a kid and you felt so proud to finally be able to tie your own shoelaces? Well, today you are a grown-ass biker and you will be very proud to be able to adjust your own suspensions. Hello adventurers, my name is Diogo Guerra and this is Off-Road, of course. Again, I have kidnapped the T7 from Bluemotor so I can finish this mini-series about motorcycle suspensions. Today we are finally going to learn how to adjust the compression and the rebound. But before you accept my teachings, a few disclaimers. First, I'm not a suspension expert, I'm not even a professional racer. I am just a guy that has been making mistakes for longer than you. Maybe not even that. Second, as we all know, adventure motorcycles, adventure riders and adventure environments are as diverse as Elton John's sunglass collection. And unlike the spring preload and the sag that we discussed on the previous video, when you talk about compression and rebound, there are no specific mathematical formulas or ratios. It's basically a Wild West where every cowboy must find their own preferences that work with their own horses on their own prairies. Third, I will be assuming you saw my last two videos about suspensions. And fourth, don't be afraid to experiment. It's perfectly possible and easy to return your bike to the factory settings. As a matter of fact, that's exactly the first thing we need to do. So let's go back to my provisory lab in Bluemotor so I can teach you how to do this. The first step is to make sure that your suspensions are adjusted to the factory settings. Even if you are the first owner of your motorcycle, there's a big chance that the suspensions are not exactly as they should be. We will begin with the front fork and we need to go to the owner's manual to see what we can find there. There's a link in the description. On the manual, we will learn that the front rebound has a total of 17 clicks.
Actually, it's a total of 31 clicks. There seems to be a faulty manual out there, so be careful.
And the factory setting is precisely 17 clicks counting anti-clockwise. So let's do exactly as they say. We will use a flathead screwdriver and we will click the rebound all the way clockwise first. And now we will go anti-clockwise 17 clicks. 1, 2, 15, 16, 17. And now, of course, we have to do the same on the other leg. Again, I will remind you not to increase or decrease the adjustments beyond their limits. If you feel any sort of resistance, stop clicking. To adjust the front compression, first you need to remove this rubber cap on the bottom of the fork. You can use a small flathead screwdriver or any other weapon of your choosing. Removing the cap will expose the clicky thingy. Again, according to the manual, this one has a total of 19 clicks.
But no, it's 22 clicks on the correct manual. I'm sorry guys, I only noticed this mistake when I was editing this video.
And the factory settings, it's 11 clicks anti-clockwise. All the way clockwise, and when we reach the end, we start counting back 11 clicks. And then remember to repeat the same for the other leg. The compression here has a total of 18 clicks, and the factory setting is 15 clicks anti-clockwise. So it's the same deal, go all the way clockwise, until you find the end, and then count back anti-clockwise 15 clicks. 13, 14, 15. Brilliant! The owner's manual tells us that the rebound adjustment has a total of 23 clicks. And the factory setting is go clockwise all the way to the end and then count back 13 clicks. 12, 13. Alrighty then, and now that the bike is set to the factory settings, we can start fiddling with the compression and the rebound to try to adjust it our own way. And welcome back to sunny Portugal, the land where men have conquered the seven seas. Just like you will now conquer the treacherous waters of suspension adjustment. What makes this endeavor so tricky is that sometimes the feedback you get from the bike when you have a high compression or a high rebound is exactly the same you get when you have a low compression or a low rebound. It's only through methodical trial and error that you can keep testing this until you zero in on a setting that really works for you. On adventure bikes, usually riders try to find a suspension adjustment that is a compromise between a comfortable and a smooth ride and one that allows us to ride fast and deal with the unknown efficiently. So, for the tests, I suggest that you find an area that explores your skill range. One that pits you against the most common obstacles you find when you ride. From pesky potholes to steep hills, not forgetting about the rocks and the mud and the sand or even jumps if you are into that. Basically, you need an area or a track that represents your usual adventure environment. But before you go all off-road off course on the track, please get two of these things and let's tie them to the suspensions. Make them tight so they don't fall down. We will use this technique to know how much suspension travel we are actually using on our tests. Because it's utterly impossible to adjust all the adjustments at the same time, we will begin with the shock compression. The compression is usually easier to adjust than the rebound, especially to us casual riders, because it directly affects how comfortable the motorcycle feels, especially on the front wheel. On the rear wheel is more about traction and stability. So go around the track and try to find an area with some potholes, water washouts, or compact dirt that has some sort of solid features like ripples or something. Go through these features at different speeds, sometimes accelerating, sometimes coasting, and try to get a feel for the rear wheel. But try to deal with one obstacle at a time, because for instance if you try to go over a series of potholes, the rebound will come into play and that's not what we are testing right now. If you feel that the motorcycle is hitting these things too hard and almost slowing down as it moves through these features, then probably your compression is too hard. Also, don't forget to look at your zip tie and try to draw some conclusions from its position. If you were riding at low speeds and going through trivial obstacles and yet the zip tie moved all the way down, then possibly your compression is too soft. If on the other hand you were riding really fast through really hard obstacles and yet the zip tie is like halfway down or something like that, then probably your compression is too hard. Because at this stage you will have no idea what you are doing, I suggest that you do big adjustments at a time. So if you decide to go for a harder rebound, go 4 clicks harder. If you decide to go softer, go 4 clicks softer. This will give you a better and a stronger feedback, so you know if you are going in the right direction. Keep repeating this process until you can zero in on a compression adjustment that works for you. The rebound affects how fast the suspension recovers after being compressed. The rebound is a bit more tricky than the compression, mainly because us, the casual riders, don't ride fast and aggressive enough to fully feel the effects of a bad or a good rebound setting. I'm speaking from personal experience, so take this with a grain of salt. Regarding the rear wheel, I usually feel the effects of the rebound when I'm trying to accelerate through a sequence of hard features like potholes or something. So that's exactly what I suggest you do. Different speeds, sometimes accelerating, sometimes coasting, and try to regulate the preload so that the bike gives you a planted and a cushy feeling. If the rear wheel feels good in the first few potholes, but then it becomes harder and harder as you reach the last ones, this probably means your rebound is too hard, so it's decompressing too slowly. Alright, and before we move to the fork adjustments, just go and test your compression again, just to make sure it's working well in tandem with the new rebound adjustment. A bunch of loose rocks you can probably find on the dry riverbed or something like that, it's ideal to test both the compression and the rebound. If on that situation the bike remains smooth and stable and with a lot of traction, then you are probably doing well. For the front fork, we will also begin with the compression. So make sure your zip tie is all the way up and then go ride. Try the same kind of obstacles you did before for the rear compression, and look for the same signs. Hard hits on potholes, general discomfort when riding over rough terrain, or feeling every little thing on the ground is usually a sign of a hard compression. Don't forget to check the zip tie for reference to know how much stroke you are using, and also keep in mind that modern adventure bikes should ride over things this size like they are a magic carpet. You shouldn't feel anything smaller than this. So if you do, probably you could soften the compression a little bit more. If on the other hand your compression is too soft, you will notice that the zip tie will be moving all the way down to the bottom of the extension, even though you are not riding that fast and over such big obstacles. It's perfectly fine to use all your suspension travel when you deal with serious obstacles. But if you bottom out the suspension for everything you encounter on the road with your usual riding style, no bueno. Again, and just like we did on the rear, go for big adjustments at first. 4 clicks harder or 4 clicks softer, so you can realize in which direction you should be going and then narrow down to one that really works for you. A soft or a fast rebound will often make the front feel too nervous and reactive to everything on the ground. And during turns, it will make the front wheel have a tendency to understeer more than it should. If the opposite happens, the rebound is too hard or too slow, you will feel the front a bit sluggish and hard to move, for example, when you are braking on a rough surface. During turns, the bike will have a tendency to oversteer. For me, feeling confident on the front wheel during turns is my biggest priority when setting the front rebound. But I also like to keep the front rebound just slightly too fast so that I can lift the front wheel off the ground a few inches without too much body input. This allows me to trample over slightly bigger obstacles without moving too much. In the end, this is all about you finding your own riding style. To be honest, it's feeling a bit weird to leave you guys with these ideas and guidelines, but no precise information. But it is what it is. Nevertheless, I feel that this video was a bit short on information, so I will put on the description a list of things that you might feel from the bike, feedback you get from the bike, and what adjustments you can do to correct it. All right. My next video will probably be another motorcycle review, a la off-road of course, but here in Portugal they are going to lift the COVID-19 restrictions. So pretty soon I hope to have another great adventure video to share with you. As usual, like it, subscribe, hit the thingy and share. Happy rides!